What happened to Ronnie?
He was killed by CPD on October 12, 2014, 5300 South King Drive.
Can you tell me more about what he was doing at that time, that day, what led to this?
He was at a party over there in that neighborhood, and the car that he was in had got shot up, and he jumped out and ran. In the process of him running, he was murdered.
And you are accusing CPD, Chicago Police, of not only, you say, killing him, but sitting on the tape. Tell me why
yes.
you think that.
Because this happened a year ago, and I've been fighting since then to get the video released, and they still haven't released it.
What is the reason they've given you as far as why they haven't released it?
If I could maybe jump in on that.
Please do, Michael.
We filed a federal civil rights lawsuit shortly after the shooting and the killing of Ronald Holmes. Immediately, the city went in and obtained a protective order from the federal judge asking that the video not be released. I then filed a Freedom of Information request to get the video that was denied by the Chicago Police Department and the city. We have since filed a FOIA, or Freedom of Information Act, lawsuit to get the video released. The city and the police have been blocking us at every step. They don't want this video released. They've sat on this 8 days prior to the Laquan McDonald shooting, and here we are again, same old story, covering this up. And all they've done is tried to keep this quiet so the public can't see it, so the people that need to see this to know what's going on in this police department can't see it.
So here you are, both of you, fighting to have this, you know, the tape of Ronald released and his death that night last year. And Dorothy, to you, now, you know, here you see this video of Laquan's death. Have you watched the video?
Have I watched which video?
Not the video of your son that you're trying to have released, but the video of Laquan who was killed after your son when he was shot 16 times.
I couldn't watch it after I seen the first shots when he went down. I couldn't watch it no more after that.
What can you explain the emotions you were feeling, especially after going through what you did days before with your own son?
It brought back a lot of memories, and it brought back memories to what I had seen on the tape of my son.
Michael, we've reached out just to try to get some sort of side of the story from Chicago Police. We reached out to Chicago Fraternal Order of Police. We've gotten nothing from them so far, although their spokesperson has told other outlets that since the shooting that Dorothy's son, that he had a gun and that he pointed his gun at officers before he was shot. I know you disagree. You tell me your version of events, please, sir.
So the night this happened, the Chicago Police Department issued a statement through their spokesman that said, as they always do in these police shootings, that he turned and pointed a gun. They feared for their safety, so the officer fired for his protection and the protection of others. Well, that was before they saw the video. The video is very clear in that, number one, he does not have any weapon in his hand or anything in his hand. He is running full speed away from the police. The officer got out of his car, took three steps, aimed towards Ronald Johnson's back and fired five shots. Two of those shots struck him, one went through the back, severed the jugular vein and went out through his eye socket. The police then say that when he fell, they recovered a gun from his right hand. First of all, he never turned and pointed anything. He never even turned, and that's clear on the video. Since then, the police have changed their story about him turning. They've been caught in a bundle of lies. The lies keep continuing. There's no way that gun was in his hand. There was nothing in his hand. And we are alleging and we believe, and it's clear, that they planted that gun after he was executed by Officer Hernandez.